एवरीवन, माय नेम इज आशुतोष बहुगुणा। आई एम वर्किंग एज अ साइंटिस्ट विद इंडियन कंप्यूटर इमरजेंसी रिस्पांस टीम। इन दिस सेशन वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द साइबर सिक्योरिटी एक्सरसाइज मोर फ्रॉम द परस्पेक्टिव ऑफ एज अ टूल फॉर जनरेटिंग द एश्योरेंस। इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डीप इन टू द साइबर सिक्योरिटी एक्सरसाइजेज एज इट इज वन ऑफ द वाइडली अडॉप्टेड मेथड फॉर एसेसिंग द cyber security preparedness of the target participants and the sectors. Exercises also used for improving the posture of an entity by identifying the gaps, creating the improvement plans. As we have already discussed, let's go through the definition of assurance and benchmarking. Again, the assurance is a state of mind in which one is free from doubt, and this is different from the confidence. It's defined in this ISO standard also, in a security assurance framework. It's a demonstrated ability of an entity to perform its security objectives. So it's demonstrated, that means it's supported by the evidence. So assurance is determined from the evidence produced by the assessment process of an entity. So we must have some assessment method to generate that evidence which will give us the assurance on the cybersecurity posture of an entity. And then benchmarking is the assessment against the standard and best practices. So cybersecurity assurance and benchmarking, as we have already discussed, that we have collected the data from the different countries, 16 different countries, to understand the global scenario and identification of different methods, practices adopted for cybersecurity posture assessment. And in that, we have discussed there were significant categories. One of the category was the cybersecurity exercises. So cybersecurity exercises as a tool to generate the assurance, to enable the entities to assess their preparedness and to generate the assurance. So that was one of the type of methods adopted widely by the different countries and sectors to improve the cyber security. Let's understand what the cyber security exercises are. There are a different type of exercises with different objectives. Here, our cyber security exercises are more focused on the exercises related to the assurance activities. So there are exercises like that, you know, capture the flag exercises or hack the target, bilateral between the countries. Here, our exercises, when we talking about cybersecurity exercises, it's more related to the generating the fact-based assurance that how the entity is prepared to counter the cyber attacks. So here, the definition goes, cybersecurity exercises are used for benchmarking the cybersecurity readiness of the entity. So participating entity and improve preparation and coordination and cooperation among entities. So exercises basically help to assess the cybersecurity readiness of the participant and improve their preparation to counter cyber attacks, cyber threats, and that improve the coordination and cooperation among entities, because in cybersecurity you need to improve the coordination and cooperation to counter the cyber attack and the threats. So around the globe, different type of cybersecurity exercises with different objectives and different frequencies are conducted regularly. So cybersecurity exercises can have a different objectives. So objective like to assess the preparedness, to enable the organization, to create awareness, to improve the coordination, to test the standard operating procedures. So, and there are different frequencies like annual exercises or the quarterly are conducted by the different entities, the national CERs, international organizations, forums, they conduct the different type of exercises. So, if you like to go into details, there is ENISA, European Forum. From there, you can search for the report on national exercises. Stop taking report. There are the analysis and details of different exercises conducted across the globe. Depending on the objectives, exercises could be sector-specific drills. Sector-specific drills means, let's say, for a finance sector, for an energy sector, for oil and gas. So we can design the sector-specific scenario. And then the participant of that sector play in that exercise, and we do the assessment. We find out the if there is any need of improvements. So those are the sector-specific drills or exercises. National cybersecurity exercises, that is conducted at a national level. Cross-sector, these exercises are conducted. And how the country, how the sectors will cooperate, will coordinate during the cyber crisis or a cyber attack. There are bilateral exercises between two entities or between two countries. How they will react to, how they will jointly fight a cyber threat, how they can help each other, that can be assessed and improved by bilateral exercises. Then there are multilateral exercises where multiple entities, multiple nation countries participate together. They learn from each other, from these exercises. They improve their cooperation and coordination at a global level, at a regional level. They understand the protocols followed by the other countries and what type of expectation when we are reporting incidents, sharing information are there. So these exercises help to have a more maturity in terms of a cyber security preparedness. There are international and regional exercises for improving incident handling. So basically the different incident handling team, national incident handling, sector specific, sector incident handling team are participating in those exercises, and they are learning from basically from each other on the emerging threats, how to handle that, how to respond that, how to improve the cooperation and coordination at the regional level in a cyber security. So such exercises like Asia Pacific CERT drill, Organization of Islamic Countries drill, ASEAN CERT incident drill known as ASIR, and bilateral exercise between the countries and countries. So in India, we participate in all these exercises. So for our organization, the selection of exercise, how they can use exercises, or for the organization with a cyber security responsibility of a sector, or for a national entity having a responsibility for assurance, how they can use the cyber security exercises. So to understand that, there are a different type of exercises, cyber security. We call that, we divide them, functional exercises and discussion-based exercises. So in a discussion-based exercises, that is generally a lightweight exercises, and it's more on a sitting in a meeting or a conference room and have quizzes to assess the awareness or understanding level of the participants, walk through some standard operating procedure or a cyber crisis plan, management plan, or to conduct a tabletop exercises. So in tabletop exercises, scenario, a crisis or an incident scenario is presented to the participants, and they have to react. How they will react to that scenario is assessed. Then where is the gap and where is the improvement required, that is assessed in the tabletop exercise. Another type of exercises are functional exercises, where the exercises can be simulated attack based or hypothetical scenario based exercises. In simulated attack based exercises, the attacks are simulated by exercise team on a participant. So basically the exercise team or exercise coordinating team is launching the attack on the target setup. In hypothetical scenario based exercises, the injects, that means the piece of information related to the cyber security development, related to the incident, is sent to the participant. So that is the hypothetical scenario, that is the part of a story. So real attacks are not involved in the hypothetical scenario based exercise. In simulated exercises, again, we can have a artifact based exercises or a real time simulation of attacks. So in artifact based exercises, the artifacts of an attack, artifacts of the incident, like a packet capture, like a malicious malware sample, like a forensic image of a system, is shared with the participant with a context, with a story, and then they have to analyze it, perform the root cause analysis, incident investigation, and respond to that given artifact. In simulation based exercises, the attacks are launched, so the target setup is created and hosted by the participant on that there could be the announced or unannounced exercises. In announced exercises, the exercise day is known, and at that day, exercise coordinator, exercise coordinating team launch the attack, simulated attack on the target setup, like a distributed denial of service attack, like a remote code execution, like hacking their website, defacing their home page, sending them a malware through the email or a web. So those attacks are done in a real time simulation. In unannounced scenario, the time of exercise is not announced, and exercise team, without announcing the schedule of the attacks, launch the, so it brings a surprise element to the participant. So like we have discussed these exercises, which is walkthrough tabletop, these can be easily conducted, planned and conducted by your organization. Similarly, we have discussed this simulated attack based, artifact based, and then hypothetical scenario based exercises. So hypothetical scenario based exercise focus on assessing the effectiveness of security plan. How effective is your security plan? Coordination and communication. How effective is your coordination and communication? Your standard operating procedures. It contains a hypothetical crisis situation which by means of inject means the piece of information, unfold through different phases. So there is some inject which says that suppose a security analyst announced that there is a possibility of cyber attack on a critical sectors. So that is a piece of information. How you will react to that information? Then there could be the injects which, when going through the unfolding scenario, that which says that there is a possibility of a targeted attack against your organization. Now, how you will react to that situation? So hypothetical or a hybrid. Hybrid means you have a hypothetical story with a real artifact. Real artifacts means you generated packet capture forensic images in the lab, and you are providing that with the your storyline. So this is the generally the exercise flow, the steady state, discovery, indication, attack, event, impacts and mitigation. So in a steady state, when there is a news or no attack is there on your organization, what you are doing, or you are maintaining the situational awareness, whether you are getting the different intelligence feed during that steady state, whether you are maintaining repository of the advisory and alerts released by different security vendors and the agencies. Then the next phase of information flow is the discovery indication. That means something, some abnormal is there in your network. So how you are going to react to it? There is an indication, there is a possibility that the attacker trying to penetrate into your network. Then there is an attack event. Attack means that attacker compromise your system, taken out your data or things like that. So they compromise your systems and they are inside your network. And there is an impact phase. In impact phase, that means attacker is able to achieve his objective. So impact can be like defacement of your homepage of your website. Impact can be your sensitive information from your organization is leaked in a public domain, impact can be the destruction of your critical services, and then the mitigation phase in which you respond to the situation, you take the mitigation, you take the controls to fix that flaw, you do the root cause analysis, you cooperate, you coordinate with the different agencies to bring down the impact of that incident. So this is how this exercise of a hypothetical story with a artifacts flow. This is the type selection. This is the recommended for the organization how to start with, since there are a different type of exercises. In x-axis there is effectiveness in assessing ground level situation. So ground level situation means the how exactly your team can respond to the cyber attack. So there is a effectiveness. So if you move to the right, those exercises are more near to the assessing the ground level situation. Then y-axis is maturity of organization, information security plan. So if today organization is not having any plan in place, any policies in place, the exercise will not be useful. Exercise will only be useful when you have something in place, like you have a plan, you have a team to react to it, and then you are doing the assessment by the exercise. So this is the suggestion: start with the walkthrough, conduct the quizzes, conduct the tabletop exercises. So these type of exercises, as the maturity will grow, you can conduct. Then you mature, you considering the artifact-based cybersecurity exercise. Then announced, and then move to the unannounced as you mature, as your information security plan mature. Really, then you move to the right end, rightmost column, where the hypothetical cyber incident-based exercises, has hypothetical cyber crisis scenario-based exercise, can consider to conduct. And the full simulation, that real life production environment. So you create a replica of your infrastructure and have an attack launched on that setup, and then you react to it and assess how prepared your team, your organization, your plan and procedures are. So to start, these are the recommendations. Start with basic exercises, and exercise must cover all people, process and technology. So exercise's objective, if it is to assess and generate that evidence, it must consider the people, skills of people, trainings of people, the process which is in place and the technology. So your exercise design should cover these things. With maturity of security plan, move to the advanced security exercises as we discussed. Learning of exercises. So you, in the end of exercises, you collect the lesson learned. So those lessons learned of exercise should be used for planning next level of a exercise. So this is how the simulated attack based exercises planned and look like. So at a exercise coordinator end, different virtual attack location can be created from the different IP or geographical locations. And through the internet or a VPN, different participating teams are there, and they have hosted exercise setup, and now the exercise coordinator will launch them to attack and monitor their progress, and collect the, both the participant and exercise coordinator will jointly make a exercise report and improvement plans. So what typical tools are required and systems are required are the exercise coordinator need to have some real-time messaging server with the participating team so that they can communicate in a real-time. They know about the flow of an exercise. There is a need of an incident response system at exercise coordinator end. Why they are needed is that exercise coordinator may need to play the different roles, like of a ISPs, like of a national CERT. So they can simulate that role from incident response systems when participating is writing to the that entity. Attacker coordinator. So attacker coordinator means launching the attack on the participant, like a phishing attack, like a recon attack, scanning the networks of the participant, doing the vulnerability assessment, or uploading the web cell on the target machine. So this is the those attacks are launched by the attack coordinator from the different locations. Exercise status website is maintained to give the picture to participant. This is the status, this is the where the exercise is, and at what time we are going to take up the next inject or a next attack and things like that. Then main exercise coordinator is collecting the learning and coordinating the exercise, communicating with the participant. So there is a provision in exercise that participant, if due to the emergency, they can withdraw from the these exercises. So they can communicate if there is any emergency within the organization. So at a player end, what type of a setup is required is generally they need to create this firewall. That can be the virtual firewall. They need to implement some intrusion detection system to detect any abnormal behavior. Traffic monitoring capture, packet capture system, traffic monitoring they can have. Investigation and analysis systems for doing the root cause analysis of the incident. Investigation, artifact analysis they can do. Coordination and response to coordinate with different external and internal entities. So they can send the email using the telephone, VC, video conferencing, things like that they can use during the exercise. Then there are a virtual machine setup, which is a target setup, which the drill team, exercise coordinator is trying to compromise. So there, that is the target of an exercise. So there, the organization need to protect it and detect any abnormal behavior, respond to that, coordinate with different agencies. In a hypothetical scenario, basically there is an exercise coordinator, main coordinator, and there is a moderator for different stages. So moderators are for the steady state. So what that he is assigned with the responsibility to send the inject artifacts of the steady state and to generate any new, that is the based on the situation, any new driven injects. So participants suppose is requesting for any new information, so moderator for steady stage of will release that to that particular participants. So similarly, the discovery, attack stage, impact stage, and this final mitigation stage of the scenario, the different moderators are there who are sending the injects, creating a new injects based on the participants in a team, and monitoring the performance of the organization. So indeed, what can be the evaluation parameters adopted for the exercises? You can make that evaluation, which generally is done by the internal observer of the participants and the exercise coordinator. But they can look for the, this is the indicative list, effectiveness of steps for securing setup. So what steps are taken by whether the participating organization able to protect the, that vulnerable infrastructure, that exercise setup, how effective they were. So that will be the assessed by the how many attacks are successful on that their target setup. Attack successfully detected and defended in this, attack successfully detected and defended in this, the exercise coordinator can see how many attacks are detected by the participating entity and how many they are able to stop. Then the attack successfully detected but not defended. So there may be the attack which were detected but organization were not able to defend against it, but not able to stop it. So then attack detects how many attacks are missed, evidence collection, whether participating organization were able to collect all different type of evidence related to the attack. Attack analysis, attacker IP, what type of a methodology is adopted by the attacker. That analysis or a root cause analysis, vulnerability which was exploited by the attacker, whether that is identified or not. Effectiveness of mitigation and recovery actions. So how the effectiveness, what was the effectiveness, what the mitigation action and recovery actions taken by the entity, how effective those were. Coordination and communication, how their coordination and communication with different entities at a sector level, at a national level, internal coordination, law enforcement agency, how their coordination was. And then effectiveness of response and reporting framework, how effective they were, how quick they were in doing the response and report the incident to the different agencies. So in exercise setup, generally what is required is the use of a virtualization technology, virtual networks, monitoring, detection, analysis system, communication channels like internet relay chat, email, telephone, incident response and coordination system, analysis systems, red team systems from the attack where the attacks are launched, analysis systems in which the investigation is done, traffic generators, so that is generating the normal traffic on a target setup. HOTWAS is the concept which is immediately after the exercise, this need to be done. So the goal of this HOTWAS is to identify the strengths and weakness of the response. So the team after the exercise sit together and participants and they analyze what worked well and what needs improvement. So just after the exercise they collect these thoughts and create a HOTWAS report. What person or component department they needs to be responsible for said improvements. So we can identify during that HOTWAS discussion that who need to implement these improvements. Assignment and timelines for corrective and proactive improvements. So if there is any corrective and proactive improvement need to be done, that the assignment and timeline can be assigned in that HOTWAS report. And then they document the improvement plan. So this is just after the exercise and takeaway, the critical takeaway from the exercise. This internal observer can also be used in exercises. Internal observer is a neutral entity for self-assessment. So internal observer is a employee of the same entity, but he is assessing the performance of his own team, but he is not interfering with their response. So he silently is writing his own report how their organization is in doing in countering cyber threats. So internal observer record expected action from organization, record actual action taken by organization, identify gaps and provide recommendation and inputs to improvement plan. So after the exercise, internal observer also share their report with the team within their organization and to the exercise coordinator also. So generally exercise day is divided like this. If exercise for full day, so 9 to 10 for 1 hour, they used to conduct the setup check and login for the communication channels. Then they start with the exercise and scenario is executed, and post exercise the HOTWAS is conducted for 1 hour. So in scenario that simulated attack based exercises, it's follow the cyber kill chain concept. And in which the attacker first do the information gathering like in a reconnaissance phase and target the vulnerability scanning of the target, what type of weakness are there, then installation of backdoor, web cells and command and control server, and finally the attacker the actions on objective like data exploitation and defacement of a website. So these are how the exercise is defined. Participants' actions. So what is expected from participant is that before exercise, they will plan for exercise, do the resource allocation and prepare the setup. During exercise, the injects and attacks, detection, any abnormal behavior detection, reporting and response to those attacks. Attempt of attack detection, reporting. If there is even an attempt of an attack and that attack is not successful, it should be detected and reporting should be done. Log traffic and alert analysis, artifact analysis, root cause analysis need to be done. Incident reporting, response and coordination to be done during the exercise. After exercise, it's expected to submit the observer and exercise report to the exercise coordinator. Preparation and implementation of improvement plan by organization, and then they have to prepare an improvement plan and the roadmap for that implementation. So this was about the how the simulated attack based exercises were conducted. Similarly, we have discussed about the cyber crisis tabletop exercises. These are can be adopted by organization for having the discussion in informal settings of the decision makers, senior people, and these exercises basically have the team members met in an informal setting to discuss their roles, during a cyber crisis and their responses to the particular emergency, how they will react to that situation. So a facilitator, exercise coordinator, guide the participant through a discussion on one or more scenario. So the scenario is presented there, and then there is a playbooks. In the playbooks, the organizer have to work how they will respond to the given situation, followed by the same hot was the to discuss what need to be improved, what was good, and the creating the improvement plan. So in earlier also we have given you the snapshot of how the cyber security, what type of exercises are conducted in India. We have annual exercises, cyber crisis tabletop exercises series that is conducted on a continuous basis for different critical sector organization, government organization, different entities. We conduct the sector specific exercises like, you know, for the finance and energy sector. We have international exercises. We participate in international exercises also to improve the bilateral cooperations. We learn from each other. So that's how the cybersecurity exercise emerges as a useful tool for improving the cybersecurity posture at an organization level, at a sector level, at a national level, and will help the organization to start with, to include the cybersecurity exercises in their cybersecurity plan or a program. So in this session we have discussed about the different type of cybersecurity exercises, like a simulated attack based exercises, hypothetical scenario based exercises, discussion based exercises, how a organization can use cybersecurity exercises as a tool to improve their cybersecurity preparedness. Thank you.